Hello, 大家好, 你们今天好吗? This is John from espressochinese.com. How are you doing? I wish you all the best. Last Sunday, I told you a funny story about one of my students said a bad word to me in my class by accident. She said, 你妈, instead of 你好吗? Actually, you know, 你妈 is a bad word. Literally means your mother's something, but she didn't recognize it at that moment, so it's quite funny. I got some comments from my listeners. People love this short story. Rob said, 很有意思. He said it in Chinese, 很有意思. 我也总是害怕我会说错话. 例如, 请问不是请问. Okay, I try to explain a little bit. He said, 很有意思. Very interesting. 我也, I also, 总是, always, 害怕, afraid of, 我会说错话, I will speak wrong words. 例如, they give me an example. 例如, that's a really good example, actually. 请问,不是请问. You know, in Chinese, if you want to say, may I ask, you may say, 请问. Literally, 请, please, 问, ask. 请问, please ask, may I ask? But 问 is fourth tone, 问. If you pronounced it by mistake, you say 请问, 问, third tone, means to kiss. If you say 请问, sounds like please kiss. Please kiss me or kiss other people, you know? So that's quite funny, you know? Because kind of you want to be very polite, may I ask, but by accidentally you said, please kiss me, something. So, very funny. Sometimes the tones matter. Today, I'm gonna tell you another interesting story. That day, only me and a lady in the elevator. What happened? It was not like what you might think, but it is funny. Let's listen to the story first. Again, I will translate it. Then I explain some important words and the structures, so that will be a lot of fun. So please wait until I translate the structures, okay? So then we listen to it one more time to make sure you understand. Finally, we will practice those words together to make it very useful for you. Please check the description to find the script for the story. And you can download my free but very useful ebook if you haven't already. Find it in the descriptions too. All right, here we go, two times.
First time.
我的教室在24楼，所以我每天要坐电梯上下楼。一天晚上大概6点半。在电梯里，有一个女的正在打电话。因为电梯里很安静，所以我大概可以听到电话那头的声音。你在哪儿呢？
在电梯里呢，
你去哪里呀？
我去学韩语。
什么？学汉语？你一个中国人。学什么汉语？
是韩语，不是汉语。你傻吗？
哦哦，知道了。那你几点结束？我去接你啊。
不用了。我自己打车回去吧。
好吧，那你注意安全，回来给你做好吃的。
Second time。
我的教室在24楼，所以我每天要坐电梯上下楼。一天晚上大概6点半，在电梯里有一个女的正在打电话。因为电梯里很安静，所以我大概可以听到电话那头的声音。你在哪儿呢？
在电梯里呢，
你去哪里呀？
我去学韩语。
什么？学汉语？你一个中国人学什么汉语？
是韩语，不是汉语。你傻吗？
哦哦，知道了。那你几点结束？我去接你啊。
不用了，我自己打车回去吧。
好吧，那你注意安全，回来给你做好吃的。
Let's do the translation first, then I will explain some important words and phrases. It will be more fun, so don't go away, I will see you there. First, translation.
我的教室在24楼。
So my classroom is on the 24th floor.
所以我每天要坐电梯上下楼。
So I have to take the elevator up and down every day.
一天晚上大概六点半。
One night at about 6:30.
在电梯里有一个女的正在打电话。
A woman was on the phone in the elevator.
因为电梯里很安静。
Because it was very quiet in the elevator.
所以我大概可以听到电话那头的声音。
So I could roughly hear the voice on the other end of the phone.
男的。
The man said,
你在哪儿呢?
Where are you?
女的, the woman, 在电梯里呢,
in the elevator.
男的,
the man,
你去哪里呀?
Where are you going?
女的, 我去学韩语。
The man, the woman, I'm going to learn Korean.
男的,
the man,
什么?学汉语?
What? Learn Chinese?
你一个中国人学什么汉语?
You a Chinese people. Why you need to learn Chinese?
女的, the woman, 是韩语,不是汉语。
It's Korean, not Chinese.
你傻吗?
Are you stupid?
男的, the man,哦哦，知道了。
Oh, I see.
那你几点结束?
So, what time do you finish?
我去接你呀。
How about picking you up?
女的。
The woman.
不用了。
No.
我自己打车回去吧。
I will take a taxi back by myself.
男的。
The man.
好吧。
Well.
那你注意安全。
Then be careful.
回来给你做好吃的。
When you come back, I will cook something delicious for you.
Okay, now the fun and the important part. Let's explain some important things.
Okay,
at the beginning, 我的教室在二十四楼，我的教室 ，my classroom， 在二十四楼。You know， 在 could be to be at in on， here is kind of on 二十四楼 24th floor。
It's interesting， you know。In Chinese， how do you say 1, 2, 3？
Yeah， we say 1, 2, 3。But how do you say first， second， third？
It is
第一、第二、第三。We just put the D。Before number to make it first, second, third, 第一、第二、第三。
So, actually, 24th floor, in English you say 24th, not 24. So, it should be 第二十四楼, right?
Yeah, that's grammatically correct. We should say 第二十四楼.
But no one say 第 in that case. Everybody say 24th floor. It doesn't mean 24 floors, it means 24th floor. Okay? For example, you live on the second floor, you don't need to say 第二楼, you just say 二楼. I suppose because people say these floors every day very often, so they just drop, everybody drop this D, so then no one say D. People just say second floor, people say 二楼, okay? 二楼, that's people's habit.
所以我每天要坐电梯, 所以, so, 我每天, I every day, 要坐电梯, I will or I need.
This 要 is a tricky one. Sometimes could be need, could be will, could be want. Okay, in that case, 每天要坐电梯, every day I, could be I need, or could be I will take 坐电梯, you know, 坐 is a sit. It's not necessary to sit, you know, in the elevator, right? But anyway, you take elevator, we say 坐电梯. Like you take bus, take train, also we use these words 坐, 坐电梯, elevator, 上下楼. 上下楼, actually, it's 上楼 and 下楼. 上楼 go upstairs, 下楼 go downstairs. But people like a short one, right? So we squeeze it, 上下楼, up, down, building.
一天晚上,
one day night,
大概,
you know, 大概 means about or roughly, in that case, let's say about 6:30, about 6:30.
在电梯里,
you know, that structure 在 something 里, it means in, in elevator,
在电梯里.
Some people may ask me, can I just say 在电梯?
在电梯有一个女的.
In the elevator, there's a woman, because you said, you just said, 在 could be to be at, in, on, so can I just say 在电梯? No, you have to say 在电梯里 to show in. Why? For example, if you say, I'm in Shanghai, okay? So in that case, you don't say 里, you don't say 我在上海里, you say 我在上海. You just say 在上海, because actually 在 to show exist, right? I exist in Shanghai, 我在上海. Shanghai is such a big city, you not really can feel you're inside some space, right? In that case, you don't need 里. You just say 我在上海, or 我在中国. 我在中国, I'm in China, 我在美国, I'm American, 我在英国, you know. This kind of a huge, big, you have no idea you're inside. In that case, you don't need inside, you don't need 里. But in the elevator, that's such a small space, obviously you feel like four walls, you know, you're kind of in this small area. In that case, you have to say 里, 在电梯里. How about in the restaurant? That's a perfect question. So the restaurant is kind of the size, not like 电梯, elevator, such small space, but not like Shanghai is so big. So both okay. You can say 我在饭店里, or 我在饭店. It doesn't matter. But when you say 我在饭店里, actually you emphasize I'm inside, not outside. Okay? So anyway, back here, 在电梯里, in elevator, 有一个女的, there's a woman, 正在打电话, you know, 正在 to show doing something, 正在打电话, it's making a phone call, 打电话, make a phone call. You know, we use 打 for some actions with your hand. For example, 打车, take taxi, right? 打 itself is a verb, means hit something with your hand, but there's many phrase with 打, it doesn't really means you hate it, it just means with your hand do something. 打电话, because you have to dial the number, right? So 打电话. Or 打车, take taxi, because you have to wave your hand, that's 打车. Okay, 打球, play ball, you have to, you know, with your hands to play ball. Of course, football, we don't say play football, we don't say 打 football, right? Because 打 is only for your hand. Football, you have to kick it. I mean soccer, you know, in American English soccer. So you have to kick it with your feet. So in that case, we don't say 打, we say 踢. Okay,
因为电梯里很安静,
because of in the elevator, 很安静, 安静, quiet, it's very quiet.
所以, so 我大概,
you know, 大概 here kind of roughly. 大概可以 roughly I can, not 100%, roughly I can. 听到听到听 means listen, but 听到 means I can hear, right? 我可以听到 For example, 听 If I ask you 听听 means listen, 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 there's the voice there, 听听、But you can say I can hear it. In that case, you won't say I can hear it. You don't say 听, you say 听到、到 has the meaning arrive. It sounds like the sound arrive in your ear, so you say 听到、我听到了、I can hear it, right? So in that case, 我可以听到 I can hear 电话那头、电话 is telephone, 那头那 that, 头 is head, that head means that end、I can hear that end、的声音声音 voice,So I can hear the voice on the other side, on the other end of the phone. Then, that's a true story, by the way. That's a real story. So the man said, 你在哪里呢? Means, where are you now? Here, 你在哪里? You know, you are where are you? People put a 呢 to have the feeling right now. 你在哪里呢?The feeling is right now, where are you? The woman says, 在电梯里呢? Again, 在电梯里, it just means in the elevator. But you put 呢 to show now. Now I'm in the elevator. 男的, 你去哪里呀? 你去哪里呀? So you go where? Why ya? Yeah, it's such a small words.Why you put ya, you just, why not just say, 你去哪里? You go where? Okay? Like English, where are you going? We put ya to show kind of I'm curious. I'm curious about where are you now. So this small word ya to show you're curious. 你去哪里呀? Because while you're in elevator, you must go somewhere, right? So 你去哪里呀?那女的，我去学韩语。I go to learn Korean. Here is the funny thing. You know, 韩语 is Korean, but how about the Chinese? Chinese is 韩语。韩语，韩语。Can you feel the difference? 韩语 what's the tone? Second tone, right? 韩，韩 going up, but 韩语，韩语 that's fourth tone going down.Right. But especially on the phone, you know, even Chinese people sometimes cannot hear very clearly, especially in a sentence. Sometimes people speak a little bit fast, it makes it even worse. So the woman said, 我去学韩语, 我去学韩语. But the man by accident, he heard the woman said, 我去学韩语, 韩语, Chinese. So the man said, what? Chinese? You're Chinese. Why learning Chinese?So the man said, 什么? What? 学汉语? Learn Chinese? 你是一个中国人? You are a Chinese person. 学什么汉语? Learn what Chinese? Right? So surprised. What Chinese? What kind of Chinese are you going to learn? It's a real story. At that moment, I was there. So I felt really funny because I'm a Chinese teacher, you know.So that's a kind of a very lively example in front of me. So that's so funny. So the woman, a little, you know, not very happy. Yeah. The woman said, 是韩语. In that case, actually, the woman make it 韩. So very long, very strong to make the man hear very clearly. So the woman said, 是韩语. 不是韩语. Like this.你傻吗? 你傻吗? 傻 is stupid, silly. That's, are you silly? 你傻吗? So, normally, don't say, you know, don't say 你傻吗 to another person. Means, are you stupid? So that's not very polite, you know. But, okay, for a woman, okay. I mean, it's a girlfriend, okay. It's okay. The man says, 哦,知道了。知道了 means I knew it. 那 we put na at the beginning of sentence could be in that case so Let's say so. 你几点结束? So you're going to learn Korean, but 你几点? What time 结束? Finish. What time you finish? 我去接你啊。So I go to 接 has the meaning pick you up. Pick up. So 接你 pick you up. 呀 this 呀 as and is such a small words to show kind of my suggestion. Kind of how about I go to pick you up.In that case, this ya, some people say ba, 我去接你吧, it's also okay, it doesn't matter. Sometimes they say ya, ba, ma, similar, very similar. It really depends. You have to consider the meaning on the context. The woman says, 不用啦, 不用啦, means no need. 我自己, me, myself, 打车, taking taxi, right?So just now we talked about 打, 打 means action with your hand. So 打车回去吧, I take taxi and go back. 吧, 吧 is also to show suggestion, kind of polite. So how about just I, by myself, I take taxi, go back. The man says 好吧, 好吧. Here 好吧 is a phrase, means okay. So instead of saying 好的,You know, 好的 or just 好 has a very positive feeling, means yes, okay. But the woman said, you don't need to come pick me up. I just go by myself. The man said, okay. In that case, if you want to say, okay, then you put 吧 after 好. Okay, so you know how to use it. You just say, okay, 好吧。那你注意安全。那 again means in that case, so.你注意安全注意是 pay attention to 安全 safe or safety pay attention to safety means, just means be careful 回来 means you come back actually you know Chinese people like drop things actually means when you came back after you came back right 回来给你做 in that case 给你做给你 kind of for you right 给 could be give or sometimes could be forIn that case, there's another verb, 做 to cook, so definitely this case is not a verb, it just means for you, right? I will for you cook 好吃的 means delicious food. In that case, people dropped food, they just say delicious, actually food, 好吃的东西, but it's okay, people like to drop it. But if you put 东西, like 好吃的东西, of course, it's okay, no problem.
我的教室在24楼，所以我每天要坐电梯上下楼。一天晚上大概六点半，在电梯里有一个女的正在打电话。因为电梯里很安静，所以我大概可以听到电话那头的声音。你在哪儿呢？
在电梯里呢。
你去哪里呀？
我去学韩语。
什么？学汉语？你一个中国人学什么汉语？
是韩语，不是汉语。你傻吗？
哦哦，知道了。那你几点结束？我去接你啊。
不用了。我自己打车回去吧。
好吧，那你注意安全，回来给你做好吃的。
Okay, great. Then let's review the vocab.
Elevator.
电梯。
Perhaps.
大概。
In process of
正在
silent
安静
sound
声音
Korean
韩语
silly
傻
end
结束
catch
接
be careful
注意安全。You can find the word list and the pronunciation in my blog. You check the link in the description. Okay, then let's use these words in the context. First, 大概, perhaps.
I'll be there at about 10 tomorrow.
我明天大概十点来。
How many of you are there roughly?
你们大概多少人?
He probably won't come.
他大概不会来了。正在 in process of.
I am reading a book.
我正在看书。
He's making a phone call now.
他正在打电话。
My wife is cooking and can't answer the phone.
我太太正在做饭，不能接电话。傻。Silly.
Silly dad.
傻爸爸。
How could he be so stupid?
他怎么这么傻?
I don't think he's stupid at all.
我觉得他一点也不傻。接, to pick up.
I'll pick you up.
我去接你。
I'll pick you up after finishing work today.
今天下班我去接你。
I'll pick you up at the airport, okay?
我去机场接你啊。Okay, well done, well done. Have you done everything correctly? If there's something different, don't worry. Maybe it's not your mistake because, you know, even the same sentence could be a different way to translate, right? So if you're not sure if you're right or not, so you're welcome to leave your sentence in the comments and I will check them for you. Thank you for listening. Again, I want to say I make this...stories for improving your listening. If you think they are useful, please leave me a comment and let me know. So I know I will make more for you. 好的，朋友们 ，see you next Sunday.